Our next caller is Kenzie from Ohio.
Hi, Kenzie. How can we help you?
Hi, guys. Nice to talk to you. I've listened to you for probably about 5 years now, so this is pretty cool. Okay. So a little background on me. I'm currently 18 weeks pregnant with identical twin girls. I'm a twin. My mom's a twin as well, so I guess it just runs in the family. My background is college soccer at Ohio State. I've ran a marathon, and then I had a hip surgery, and then I got into bodybuilding. So that was for about probably 3 years, then got engaged, so focused kind of on family. So now being pregnant with my training background, it's been a little difficult. It's not as fun to lift when I'm not lifting as heavy. That's been a little difficult. So lifting is kind of just 2 times a week maybe now, if that. So because my twins are identical, I'm high risk. So my activity has gone down a little bit. So I'm just curious, kind of getting ahead of myself, but once I have the babies and I'm cleared to work out, what is the best option to start with? Because I know my core will be really weak and probably have lost like a ton of muscle. So I'm just kind of curious with my background, but I know how to do lifts. We have a full gym in my house. So just kind of curious kind of where to go from there once the babies are born.
So Kenzie, the hardest thing for you is going to be your competitive mindset and knowing, yeah. knowing how to steer that correctly. Just hearing your background, collegiate level athlete, bodybuilder, competitor, it sounds like you're kind of a badass and you're definitely going to be in a different situation here, and starting slow and right is going to be really, really important, and you're going to be challenged to get impatient. So that was the first thing that I want to start off with.
Cut out.
Can you hear me? Well, I'm going to finish telling you tell Kenzie what I would have told her anyways, whether she can hear me or not. So the thing that I would say is that you got to be very careful on the desire to, and I know Justin will be able to speak to this really well too, because he has a competitive mindset too, is going slow and gradual, right? So the goal is always to do as little as possible to elicit the most amount of change. In your case, I think that MAP starter would be the ideal place to start. And the one thing that, again, you're going to be challenged with is if you've got a competitive bodybuilding type of background, it's not like heavy barbell squats. It's not movements like that, but it's definitely where you should be right now before you progress into something like a MAPS anabolic.
Yeah, you know, when you're training, first off, to post-pregnancy, a lot of your success post-pregnancy is going to be what you did before you got pregnant, and what you did during your pregnancy. Now, 2 days a week of resistance training during pregnancy is plenty to prevent a lot of muscle loss and to maintain some strength. So that's actually really, really good, especially considering that you're pregnant with twins, which you know makes things much more difficult. Post-pregnancy, Adam said MAP Starter. That's the best program I would recommend. Mm-hmm. If you don't have MAP Starter, or for people who are listening who aren't familiar with MAP Starter, essentially you want to train a lot of unilateral exercises, so one leg, one arm. You want to use a stability ball. You want to go light, and you want to focus on full range of motion. And you really want to practice the movements. Don't push the body. Allow your body to slowly progress. And consider this, because I've trained a lot of women pre, during, and post-pregnancy, and the 3 months post-pregnancy is the hardest. After about 4 or 5 months, then the body really starts to kick into gear. So what you're doing that for that first few months is really just getting your body to move right, getting your core to function again, because you're going to be so disconnected from some of the muscles in your core. So getting those to fire, getting everything to kind of strengthen. After about 4, 5, 6 months, then you'll start to feel, and this is the comment I used to get from pregnant women all the time, or post-pregnant women all the time, was after about 5 or 6 months, they'd come to me and say, "Oh, I'm starting to feel like myself again." Mm-hmm. And then we would start to kind of ramp things up, and then their bodies would progress rather quickly. But post-pregnancy, you're just trying to move, get your body to reconnect, because, and just for lack of a better term, during pregnancy, it feels like, and in some cases this is true, your body's not yours. Yeah. What I mean by that's not
it's transforming into something else.
Yeah,
and that's
feels very, very accurate.
Right. Yeah. Like to Adam's point, it's such a mental hurdle, especially I think for athletes to really change the mindset and change, you know, the approach towards what is sort of like, I mean, it's your home base. Like training used to be, it meant something completely different when you'd go to approach it. And so I think just really kind of putting your mind around what's going to be best, you know, in terms of like listening to your body, feeling your body as you're working out and trying to come in with more of a calm headspace. I think that, you know, that's really going to help a lot.
Yeah. So here's your two options for someone like you, because I think Adam opened it up with, and he hit the nail square on the head. Okay. Here's your two options. Either one, you go slower than you think and slowly allow your body to adjust and progress. Or here's the other thing that would probably happen with someone like you, which I've experienced with clients, is you end up injuring yourself, which is actually quite common. And that really sets you back. Your pelvic floor muscles will probably have some stuff going on there, at the very least, some disconnection with some of your pelvic floor, especially if you deliver, you know, the babies. Even if you don't, there's going to be some stuff going on. You're not connected to your core muscles. They all have to stretch. You can't fire them as well. In fact, when you're after you have the baby, when you go to do anything with your core, it's all hip flexors. You're going to feel like there's no core stability whatsoever. The relaxin hormone that or chemical that's released during pregnancy that loosens your body up. When you have twins, there's more of that. And so you're going to be a bit hypermobile, meaning you're lacking some stability. So going slow is the name of the game. And if you push yourself too hard with lack of stability, you know, pelvic floor muscles not being connected or possibly injured, which is quite common with, you know, core weakness, you can run into some problems that then become long-term chronic problems. And it's not uncommon to get, you know, to get a female client who used to be an athlete and then they had a baby and then they tried to work out on their own. Then they'd come hire me and they'd say something like, you know, after I had my son 6 years ago, I've had this chronic back pain or this chronic hip pain. And then it's like backtracking is very, very difficult. So go very slow. Take your time. You've got great muscle memory that's going to work on your side. It's going to take about 3 to 5 months for you to start to feel like your body is what it used to be, or even a semblance of it. So take your time. MapStarter, perfect program. And again, if you're listening and you don't know what MapStarter is, it's a lot of unilateral exercises, a lot of stability, and it's using a physio ball through a lot of the exercises.
Perfect. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.
No problem, Kenzie. And we're going to send you MapStarter if you don't have it, okay?
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
No problem.
Appreciate the support.
Yeah, there was a period of time where this was like, I had a lot of clients that I trained that were either pregnant, going to get pregnant, or just had a baby. Because I trained, you know, I had a studio for over 15 years, and I trained one woman, and then she was a part of like a mom's group. And so I just started getting all these moms. Just
all moms.
And the challenges with pregnancy and post-pregnancy are unique. They're very unique to anybody else. And it's literally like your core post, you know, post, you don't, it's like you don't, it, imagine having to, trying to get a muscle to contract and you don't even know how anymore. Right. That's literally what it feels like.
Out of body experience for sure.
Yeah. So you got to take your time and go slow, but I can't stress this enough. And Jessica's experienced this right now. She's obviously my wife. My son now is a little over five months old. And I just did some body fat caliper test on her. And she's down to 22% and she's just getting leaner. And she's like, what's going on? And I'm like, she's like, I'm not even working out that much. I'm only working out two or three.
Roaring metabolism.
Yeah, she's only working out a couple days
Katrina,
a week.
Same thing.
Yeah, yeah. She's working out a couple days a week because the baby's barely sleeping. So she has to focus on sleep.
Yeah.
She's like, why? She's like, this is weird. I'm like, honey, you were so consistent with resistance training before the baby and during your pregnancy that you set yourself up really well.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah, if you have all that going into pregnancy, it makes it so much easier to rebound. And then also, too, it was crazy when Courtney was breastfeeding. It was like all of a sudden it was like this fat-burning machine like turned on. And so that's another benefit to it, even though it's very difficult and it's a struggle, you know, things like that, you know, that your body, you know, will provide. It's pretty interesting.
Yeah. I would love to see her not only do starter, but I would love to see her like follow the MAPS Prime Pro webinar that I did. That is something that I would ask her to do too. I think just that'll help get her reconnected to everything.
Yeah, you got to kind of piece it back together.
Yeah, and it's something she can do on her living room floor, do it once a week in there. I think it's just a great way to get her back in the routine. The thing, whenever I hear someone like that, like right away, I think, oh man, this girl's got competitive background. She's bodybuilded before.
Oh, like, yeah. She's going to want to go too
hard. Yeah, the desire. I mean, it's just like, it's no different. I mean, it's very different than obviously my knee surgery, right? Having a baby is nothing like that. So I don't want to fucking get, I don't want all the women.
I know what it's like having
a baby. Knee baby. I don't want all the women to crucify me for saying.
I pulled my knee once.
What I mean is having a competitive mindset to get back because you know what your body's capable of. And I can relate to that, right? I can't relate to having a baby, but I can relate to the thinking that I can do much more.
I did have a hemorrhoid, though. Yeah.
when my body says I can't, and sure shit, that's exactly, I re-injured myself, set myself back 6 more months. And so, yeah, taking it slow, listening to your body is going to be crucial.
Truth be told, some of the most challenging clients I've ever trained in my entire life were ex-athletes.
Oh, yeah. They're so hard. They're stubborn.
You got to slow them down.
They're stubborn,
and they
too.
don't get it, you know what I mean? Because they have this, they just remember how their body used to be, and it's like, not the same, dude.
Yeah.